Welcome to the next chapter in TI Position Lab series on stepper motors. My name is Wang Li, and today I will discuss audible noise for stepper motor drivers. The root cause of the stepper motor audible noise could come from mechanical factor, magnetic factor, or electrical factor. Mechanical noise is caused by the physical component's vibration in the structure of the stepper motor. Common examples contributing to noise include unsecured mounting structures, bent shelves, and loosened bearings. Other mechanical noise factors include motor housing, balance of rotor, and bearing choice. All of these examples cause unnecessary vibrations and make audible noise. Magnetic noise is caused by the magnetic material expanded or contracted in response of a magnetic field. In a step motor, magnet restriction deforces the iron and pulls the rotor and the stator teeth towards each other in the air gap, causing audible noise. Electrical noise is caused by the winding current frequency component in 20 to 20 kHz audible range. There are several reasons could affect the winding current frequency component. Microstepping setting, step frequency setting, PWM frequency setting, and current deviation from the current reference setting. Mechanical and magnetic noise is related to the motor design. Electrical noise could be related to the motor driver device. This chapter is mainly focused on the electrical noise. When the driver commands a new step, similar to a pulse response, the rotor overshoots and oscillates around next position, leading to mechanical vibrations and noise. The oscillation frequency is the motor system resonant frequency. To reduce those oscillations, modern stepper drivers employ microstepping to divide one full step into smaller microsteps. As a result, the rotor is now stepped in much smaller angles, less over and undershoots, which can reduce the audible noise. If the step frequency is between 20 Hz and 20 kHz, then the step frequency and all the higher harmonics will appear in the audible range. By increasing the step frequency beyond the audible range, the audible noise is reduced, and at the same time, overall smoother rotation is achieved. In the sound pressure level plot shows, a higher level of microstepping settings allow a higher step frequency and reduce the noise for the same motor speed. If the PWM frequency falls within the audible band, the noise associated with the PWM frequency will be audible. Increasing the switching frequency is the first method to reduce audible noise. To reduce the ripple and therefore audible noise, a stepper motor should operate with a minimized ripple current. Comparing with the mixed decay or other decay mode, the slow decay can have a smaller ripple current control, which are showing in the top of this slide. The smart tune ripple control algorithm uses slow decay for current regulation, but keeps fixed ripple current instead of a fixed PWM off time as other decay modes. The test result is showing in the bottom chart of this slide. The smooth and quiet operation of a stepper motor happens when perfect sinusoidal current waveforms are applied to the windings. Any current deviation from the desired shape causes an uneven torque in the motor, which manifests as vibration and noise during operation. In the left picture, due to back EMF, especially at high speed and on decreasing steps, a fixed PWM off-time slow decay cannot apply enough voltage to the winding terminal to bring the output current back to ideal value. The smart tune dynamic decay or ripple control decay attempts to operate mostly in slow decay with the inserting period of fast decay, or extending the PWM off time to maintain the ideal waveform if the current runs away. Therefore, a smart tuned decay mode which can follow the ideal waveform at all conditions is an ideal candidate for reducing audible noise from stepper motors. To avoid the high side effect turn-on switching noise coupling to the current sense circuit, stepper motor drivers start to sense the output current after a blanking time. A high current sense blanking time could cause the average current to be significantly higher than the intended value near the zero crossing section. On the other side, a too high PWM off time could cause the average current to be significantly lower than the intended value near the zero crossing section. This distortion is to create unsmooth current waveform, which leads to wobbling, vibrations, and audible noise. TI devices can support down to 1 microsecond current sense blanking time, and different PWM off time options to give respectively smoothness current around zero crossing. For more information on stepper motors and TI integrated stepper drivers, please visit the stepper driver page on TI.com.